What I'll show you today is how to create that integration between ServiceNow and Jira and how the flow creation process works on the Unito dashboard. If you're starting a flow from scratch, the first step is to select the tool. So I'll just search for ServiceNow and Jira. All of the different Jira products are available here. Choosing the account. So essentially what account you're using to log into Jira or to ServiceNow, as long as you have full access to a table. So having the ability to create incidents, edit fields, you'll have the ability to create a flow through Unito. Same thing on this side. And then you choose the project and the table on the other side. And then confirm. The second step is to determine the direction. So where does the work originates from? It could be two-way. So anything that's created on any of the platforms gets synced to the other one. Or for the example that we're going to illustrate today is one way from ServiceNow to Jira. The third step is where you could determine which incidents are relevant for the project that you work in as the Jira admin, for example. Here, I've selected that if the category of my incident is inquiry/help, then I want the sync to be triggered to Jira and then create a matching issue of the type task. You have all of the fields that are available in the incidents table that you can leverage as triggers as well. So all of the fields that are currently, and there are many, in my incidents table and can leverage on this stage right here. You'll notice here I have a creation date rule that allows me to sync items that were created after the creation date of my flow, but it's also something that I can remove if I wanted to sync historical items, so incidents that were created before. If you have different projects with different configurations that you would want to sync items to, you can also change the settings to include the different types that are available in your Jira project. In this billing support, I only have Epic or Task, but it would update based on what's available on your Jira instance, even custom issue types. This is what makes Unito easier to use in other platforms. Instead of adding all of the triggers within one place and saying, if this, then that, but then if this, then do that, this sentence here, keep in sync, is what is going to rule the flow in general. So any task that adheres to certain criteria is going to sync over to our destination and stay up to date throughout its journey. And then you can establish that at a certain point on the incident journey, it stops syncing. For example, when it's resolved, it will no longer sync updates bidirectionally. I'll go ahead into the next section. We have the number, we have the assigned to, the color, the short description, which is the title of your incident, the description of the incident itself. And I've added other fields just to show you more extensive capabilities of the mapping customization. Other use cases that you could be leveraging Unito for, Notion, Google Calendar, GitHub. Some of these might require a bidirectional sync where items can be created on side A or in side B, and you want all of the information to be reflected for either collaboration or leadership visibility that's out of the box within your Unito flow without having to code anything or write a script just to change the direction. You can just click on a button and it will transform your flow into a bidirectional create sync. And then by clicking on the two arrows, it will automatically update the rule section where Unito will understand items can be created on either side, and you can specify, okay, well, we know that from ServiceNow to billing support, you want a sync to be triggered based on a category. But from the Jira side, you can specify different rules, only when priority is high or only when assignee is Layla, any other criteria that would meet your expectations. Here at the top of my screen, you can see that 12 out of the 87 fields that are currently accessible or available in my table can be mapped on the Unito platform. That's why we say it's easy to use, but we can do really a lot. And then you can add as many custom fields, out of the box fields, and map them between the platforms as long as you have a destination for those fields. essentially on the Jira side, I only have 33. Some of the fields are custom fields. Those are noted by a little blue question mark. I've created a custom field called reporter on my Jira just to capture the information of the caller. So the person who made the request, for example, on the ServiceNow side, because I suspected that not everyone would have a seat in Jira as well as in ServiceNow. That's why I thought having a custom field on Jira would make more sense. You can customize the configuration of a flow per project. If you know that 5 projects have the exact same configuration and the same fields are relevant for those teams, you can just duplicate the flow. So without having to change anything and essentially just copy paste and apply it to a different Jira project. And if we were to add state here, just to illustrate how Unito can allow that sort of mapping, so I'll map it to issue status on the Jira side. Unito is going to recognize that those fields have multiple levels within them, so drop down single select values. First, it's going to auto map the values that are similar, and then it's going to allow me to select and map each one as I see fit. There are some states that are different across different platforms. So I can say that new on one side equals to do on the other. Done is going to equal cancel, but also is going to equal to close and resolved. So you really have the option to map those fields one-to-one, one-to-many, without any code or script required at every little customization or tweak that you're making at the flow level. And then you can just save and then apply those changes, and you have the option to apply it historically or for new or modified items. So going into my project, I can simply click on this icon here and it will open the Jira project that is my destination. Here, as you can see, all of these items have synced from ServiceNow. I'll just go to the most recent one at the bottom, and then I'm just going to zoom in. As you can see, the description has synced over. We also have the incident number in the description footer, but I could also put it into a custom field if I had one on my Jira project. I also have a link to the ServiceNow record that will automatically take me to ServiceNow without having to search for it in the incidents table and allow me to see it in full view here if I have access to both. Or I can simply make updates directly from here. So if I were to add a comment, that will sync over to my ServiceNow, where the agent or the developer who submitted the request initially will see it as a work note directly from ServiceNow.